Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Today we are going to learn AVS. Lesson number 11, Air Around Us. We are going to learn about the air around us and moving air. So students, let's start with our first one. The air around us. Air is all around us, but it is like a big blanket that surrounds us, but we cannot see it, we can only feel it. So yes, air is all around us and we can feel the air. We cannot see it. So students, air is present all around us. Do you know that all living things need air to breathe? Have you ever seen air? Yes, air cannot be seen, but it can be felt. But how can we feel the air? Do you know this? Come, let's see. So children, how we will know that we have filled the air? Yes, you can feel air when it moves. For example, we can feel that when you swing or when you run or jump, when you play and when you ride a bicycle very fast. You can feel the air moving against your face. So this is the way we feel the air. So children, do you know that air has no smell, shape and color? It does not stay in one place. It moves from one place to another. Yes, air does not have any color, shape and smell. And air also cannot stop at only one place. It is moving all around us. So students, let us learn some more things about air. So students, do you know that air has weight? And air fills up space. Let's see that how can air has weight. For example, fill two balloons with air and tie them on a hanger. Remove air from one balloon. The other balloon drops down. This shows that air has weight. So students, what we have learned? We have learned that when we fill air in two balloons and tie it on the hanger, then after removing air from one balloon, we see that the other balloon goes down. It means that the balloon, means the air, is having a weight. Now students, let us learn about how air fills up space. Anything that has weight fills up space. Air has weight, it fills up space too. It means that any object that having weight fills up the space, and air also has a weight, so it fills up space too. For example, when we blow air into a balloon, it gets bigger in size. This shows that the air needs space. Yes, when we start blowing the air into the balloon, it gets bigger in size. It means that it needs space, air and uses of air. And also about warm air and cool air. So students, let's start with the topic, the moving air. Students, do you know that when we fly a kite, why does it move?
Yes, when we fly the kite, it moves because this happens due to the moving air. Students, do you know why does a pinwheel spin? Yes, this is because this happens also due to the moving air. Moving air is also called the wind. A gentle or a slow wind is called a breeze, and we all enjoy a cool breeze. Yes or no? Yes, we all enjoy a cool breeze. Student, when the wind is very strong and blows very fast, we call it a storm. And these storms can cause damage to trees and houses. There are different types of storms. So students, let's see it. Some storms bring in heavy rain, lightning and thunder. They are called thunderstorms. Some storms carry dust with them. These storms are called dust storms. The storms that carry sand are called sand storms. The storms which bring snowfall are called snow storms. So students, up to now we have learned about different forms of moving air. Now let us learn how air is useful to us. So let's start with uses of air. All living things need air to breathe. We also need air for burning things. For example, when a burning candle is covered with a glass, it blows out. After some time, this happens because there is no air left inside the glass to keep the candle burning. Air gives shapes to some things. For example, things like tires, balloons, and footballs. Students, things like tire, balloon, and football gets their shape only after we fill them with air. Air also helps the clothes to dry faster, and air helps boats to sail. Students, do you know air is lighter than water? Yes, air is lighter than water because things filled with air float on water. That is why swimming tubes help us to float on water. So students, now let's see about warm air and cool air. When the air becomes warm, it becomes light in weight, so it moves up. For example, if we burn some dry leaves, we can see small things get blown up in the air due to the fire. The air becomes warm and moves upward, means up. It carries the small pieces of burnt leaves up. Warm air moves faster than cold air. Let us do one activity. You should do this activity with the help of your parents. Let's start. Put a balloon on the neck of a bottle and keep that bottle in a pan of boiling water. What do we see? The balloon will increase in size. And students, what will happen if we keep the bottle in a pan of a cold water? Yes, there will be no change in the size of the balloon because warm air takes more space than cold air. So students, now let's learn some activity. We will start with fill in the blanks. Let's start with our first fill in the blanks. Air has no dash, dash, and dash. Air has no dash, dash, and dash. So what will be the answer, students? Yes,
Air has no smell, shape and color. Air has no smell, shape and color.
Let's move to the second question. Some storms bring in heavy rain, lightning and thunder. They are called dash. Some storms bring in heavy rain, lightning and thunder. They are called dash. So students, what will be the answer? Yes, some storms bring in heavy rain, lightning and thunder. They are called thunderstorms. Some storms bring in heavy rain, lightning and thunder. They are called thunderstorms. Let's move to the third question. Some storms carry dust with them. These storms are called dash. Some storms carry dust with them. These storms are called dash. So what will be the answer, students? Yes, some storms carry dust with them. These storms are called dust storms. Some storms carry dust with them. These storms are called dust storms. Let's move to the next question. The storms that carry sand are called dash. The storms that carry sand are called dash. So what will be the answer, student? Yes, the storms that carry sand is called sandstorm. The storms that carry sand are called sandstorms. So students, now let's start with the next question. Storms that brings snowfall are called dash. Storms that bring snowfall are called dash. So students, what will be the answer? Yes, storms that brings snowfall are called snowstorms. Storms that brings snowfall are called snowstorms. So students, hope you all have understood the lesson properly. Thank you.